Rescue me, rescue me, rescue me. We are down here at the shelter. It is post July 4th, and we did get quite an influx of dogs. Yes, we did, but we're slowly getting them adopted out and back to their owners, and we'd have them all back to their owners if they'd have had ID on their tags. Just have to get that in, if they had ID on their collars, rather.
I think we always have to get that in, because I even meet responsible pet owners that I know, and I suggest, do you not have your phone number on the collar? And they say, oh, yeah, I do. Look at my stuff here. I said, I cannot see it. It's all worn off. So get the phone number right on the collar with your Sharpie marker. Best way.
The best way. And I think we have some other stuff that's going to be going on
pretty
soon, right?
Yes, the Kittenpalooza. Well, we used to call it Kittenpalooza, but now we're calling it the Catpalooza. On the 25th of July, right down here at the shelter, we're going to have all cats and kittens. Half price.
Ooh.
That means $40 for a cat or a kitten.
That's amazing, because that includes the spay and neuter surgery,
everything, shots,
all that stuff.
And I hear it includes a collar as well.
Get out.
Wow.
That's just so generous.
July 25th, go and put it on your calendar. Kittenpalooza, half price, all cats and kittens, right here at the shelter on the front lawn.
Terrific.
Augie wants some attention now, I think.
Augie got some attention. If you'd have seen Augie a week ago, you would not recognize him. He was a flea-infested, matted-up mess.
No.
And then he got a grooming, and look at him now.
Wow.
He's sweet, about 4 years old, a fabulous dog, friendly, knows sit, knows a couple other commands. He's great on the leash. He likes the lap. He likes other dogs. He is just all around cool beans, basically. This is a great dog.
I like holding him. He likes being here.
Augie's ID number, 206-515.
Take me out of here.
This is a dog who is extremely beloved down here at the shelter. His name is Red. All I'm going to say is he came from a fairly nasty situation before he got here. He is a loving, calm, easygoing dog. He really likes female dogs. He's tolerant of other male dogs as long as they're not rowdy and in his face. He is just a nice guy who would be happy with another dog to hang around with, or happy just being the only dog, the beloved pet in someone's home. A great companion. He's about 6 years old. And because he's so beloved, he has half of his adoption fee paid, so that's good for your pocketbook as well as Red's costs, so it's terrific. This is a lovely dog who deserves a good future, because he came from kind of a lousy past. So please come check out Red, 205-906. I'm not sure, T, but I think Lucy might be our longest residing dog.
She is our longest residing dog, and she has a hard luck story. As well as Red's hard luck story, she's got one too.
She did. She fell out of the back of a truck, and nobody stopped to pick her back up. So a vet took care of her for a while, and then we got her. Very smart dog, very athletic dog, great running partner, jogging partner, biking partner, hiking partner, whatever you like to do, Lucy will do it with you.
And concentration, when you look her in the eyes, she's so focused on you. Do you get that when you look at her in the eyes?
I absolutely get that. I think Lucy is wicked smart. I really,
really?
Do. That is a highly intelligent dog right there.
I mean, you could
teach
this dog so many things.
And super loving, loves people, is dog selective, as many of in her breed are. But she's got a lot of playmates, including Red, who you just saw. And half of her adoption fee is paid as well, because we love her and want to get her out of here. It's no good being here with longest residing on your
your
resume.
Good at all.
Her ID number is 203-298. We love Lucy.
Deborah, we've got a volunteer favorite here.
We sure do. You know, the older guys kill us in here. Although, yep. Although Moose is like 8 years old, he does not, I think Greer will agree, he does not act like an eight-year-old dog.
Not at all.
He is full of energy. He is happy. He is playful. He is funny. You can see he's a lover and a half, and he really loves Greer.
He knows everything a dog should be, and he delivers.
He's fantastic. Someone will get a great companion with this guy. Aww. And guess what?
Half his adoption fee is paid.
Yes, so he's halfway out the door, folks. Come here. I know he's got that gray face, but come down here and meet him, because there's nothing old about Moose. ID number 206-281. This little dude is a relative newcomer to the shelter. Came in on the 6th from Atascadero, and terrified when he got here, and you would never know it now. This guy is outgoing, playful, funny, lots of energy, about 6 years old, a great little dog, and we're going to name him Benny.
And that's what the volunteers do for these dogs, Deborah. When they come in and they're scared or whatever their attitude might be, volunteers can turn that right around.
Absolutely. This one didn't take long. Some of them it's harder, but Benny came right out of his shell. 206-665. Cash is one of the most beautiful dogs in the shelter. He's also one of the most frightened. people just scare him. Somebody was not nice to him. He doesn't do anything aggressive. He avoids if he doesn't know you really, really well.
I see someone has styled his ears.
Yeah, you know, I wish we could talk people out of doing that. Yep. There's no reason to do that to a dog, and it makes people think they look scary, and it's not fair.
It's so.
Not like they do it to themselves, you know. Mm-mm. Cash's ID number is 205-792, and he's a nice guy. He needs a safe place to land. Sadie's one of the most people-loving dogs you are ever going to find. She is a lap dog. She just wants her companion. She really does not care for other dogs much at all. She just likes her people.
And she's another one, Deborah. When she looks at you, you look at her, there's that connection right there.
Smart as a whip. Uh-huh. Very smart, but just people-oriented, not dog-oriented. So if you're looking for that companion to go on walks with you, she's got fair, you know, she's kind of medium energy, but lots of, you know, she's about 3, so she's, you know, a nice calm age. She just wants her person. So if
and
you
we
can
made
be,
her volunteer pick of the month this one.
That's right, which means half of her adoption fee is paid as well, and we really love her and want to get her into a home, so she is the volunteer's pick. Sadie's ID number is 192695. This is Pongo. We have him listed as Chinese Sharpei and Chow Chow. I'm thinking the Chow Chow is not correct. I'm thinking that's a Lab Sharpei. That would be my guess. But anyway, Pongo's about 1.5 years old. He is a really nice dog, super nice dog. His owners could no longer keep him because of their housing situation, but house train, crate train, fetches, plays frisbee, is really good with dogs and kids and all that kind of stuff. House train, great dog, just needs a new home. So please come down and meet Pongo. His ID number is 206-719. This dog came to us on the 8th of July from the North County in the Theater Drive in Main Street. I can't believe no one's come to look for this dog. He's super nice. Everybody's crazy about boxers. He's just about 5 years old, good with other dogs, no sit, no shake.
He's settling right in there with MJ.
He's just an all-around super dude. So somebody come. Oh, and he's got that great little underbite. Oh. How much do you love that? I love that. We're going to call him Simon if nobody comes and claims him. And his ID number is 206-700. This is Jake. He's a lab mix. What more can I say? There's some energy in there. He's about 2 years old. He's pretty cute. Come and get him. 206-428. This is Jake. I can't believe this dog is still here. This is our Colette. She is so smart. She's very good with other dogs. She doesn't like cats, but well. But she loves other dogs. She plays hard, so she'd be a great companion dog if you have a rambunctious dog at home that needs a playmate. That would be best for her because she does play hard, but she is just a really, really super dog. Half of her adoption fee is paid, so that is $52.50 off the bill from us down here, which is great. And she's spayed and ready to go and ready for that new home. Very young, too, just turned a year.
She's a good size, nice and medium.
She
and
is.
Not a fabulous too big. Ball dog.
Not too small, not too big, all-around great gal. 205-804, this is Colette. Plus, she's got a cool French name. I mean, come on. What more do you want? Well, here's another one that's not too big and not too small. Kirby
and he's just about a puppy, Deborah.
He is. He's a baby. He's just barely a year old. He is so cute. He was found on the 6th of July in Paso Robles, Niblick and River Road. That's kind of my area over there. What a little cutie pie. Someone should be looking for him, but they're not. And so Kirby is with us and ready to go home with you. ID number 206-474. Kirby.
You see, Deborah, this guy's got one blue eye, one brown eye.
He is a gorgeous creature.
I just love that
He's
look.
Fabulous. Yeah. Great ears, too, if you'll notice
yes,
as well.
Yes, yes, yes.
Buddy's just the all-around cool package. He's about 2 years old, all-around good guy. Knows sit, down, stay. Good, very, very good ball dog. In fact, we barely got the tennis ball out of his mouth for this shooting. So come down and look at your all-American dog named Buddy. Oh, and his adoption fee is paid.
Half
holy cow.
Fee paid. You get everything with this
you
dog
do.
And a discount.
Fantastic. 206-270. This is Buddy. Oh, I love this dog. This is Cassie. She was found out in the middle of nowhere, so, you know, probably not been with a person in a really, really long time.
She's a heartbreaker, Deborah.
She's a heartbreaker, but I'm telling you, she has come a long way since she got here.
And why is that? The help
because
of the volunteers.
Volunteers and staff down here, you know, have spent time with her, teaching her that people are okay. She does like other dogs very much. In fact, she's more comfortable when she's around other dogs. And it's gotten to the point where, you know, she'll scooch close to me to get petted. She's even nudged my hand a few times, like, okay, you can touch me now. It's all right. I'm ready.
That's so rewarding.
It's incredibly rewarding. And it's the only thing that makes a dog like this adoptable. And so we need volunteers to do those things. And I'm telling you, folks, if you have a bad day, you come down here and you get a dog like this to trust you, and you feel the best that you've ever felt. It's incredible. I love volunteering. Please do. Cassie is a young female, maybe 2 or 3 years old. Her ID number is 206-566. I think she's going to make someone a wonderful companion.
You know, Deborah, it was funny to see Ruby come right out here, position herself on the mat, and that's that.
She's ready to go. Apparently, she's done acting work in her past or something. She knows what she's doing. I really like this dog. This is a very good all-around dog. She's well-behaved. She's smart. She knows sit. She knows shake. She really likes people. She likes other dogs. She's just an all-around good dog. She's about 3 and another set of fine ears, if you'll notice there. Look this way. There you go. So Ruby's a cool one.
Yeah, she's got all the checks in the right box.
She does. Good girl. 206-420. This is Ruby. Kind of stunned nobody came in to claim this dog. Picked up as a stray in San Luis Obispo. Clean and beautiful and groomed and... cannot understand why no one was down here looking for their dog, but he's still here. He's about 6 years old, we think. His ID number is 206-679. And, I mean, gosh, you know, all around beautiful, well-kept Pomeranian. Somebody wants this dog as a companion.
He might have bolted on the 4th of July and no one came here to look for him. I don't know.
I don't know either. But here he sits and he needs to get out of here. So come adopt him. Okay, people, we have a sad story. So listen up. These guys lost their home because their owner passed away. So here they are down here, not understanding why they're not in their loving home. And we would love to see them go together. It's hard to get dogs adopted together, but we would kind of like to see that if possible. But we'll adopt them out separately, too. On the left-hand side, you have Bruno, who is 4 years old. On the right-hand side, you have Piper, who is 9, so a little bit older. They are both little boys, males, and just as nice as they can be. Nothing but nice things about them said on their turn-in paperwork. And, you know, someone have a heart and come get these little guys out of here.
But, Deborah, the older one, the 9-year-old, is eligible for the senior rebate, which means that will bring down the cost if you have 2 of them together.
That's right. So
it's
that's
almost
great.
Like half price, so that would be great. If they could stay together, these two boys would love it. We would love it.
Yeah, that would be terrific. Piper is the one on the right, the white one. His ID number is 130672, and Bruto's ID number is 955442.
Deborah, do you notice how big that collar is?
I do, but what I really notice is there's no phone number written on it, there's no tags hanging from it, and there's no microchip embedded in the dog itself. That's a bummer. This dog just got here about an hour ago from Grover Beach, 13th and Newport Avenue. We think she's about 5 years old. She seems to be a lovely dog, although she's frightened here. I hope an owner is going to come get her, but otherwise she will be up for adoption, and she seems like a super dog. And we sure wish that someone would write their phone number on that collar. Maybe her new adopter will do that if her owner doesn't come find her. ID number 206-775, new dog. I know we have Mastiff fans out there in this county, and Zeus's owner could no longer keep him. Zeus does not like it here at the shelter, but he is a very nice dog. He's about 6 years old. He's a Boxer Bull Mastiff mix. He's terrific. He loves cheese, by the way. About the only way we can warm him up down here is ply him with cheese. You know, we do what it takes down here. That's what a volunteer
does.
Well, if
that's what he likes, that's what he likes.
Yeah, give him some cheese.
Exactly.
He's already neutered. He's ready to get the heck out of here. He would so love to get into a loving home for the rest of his life.
And we do have a lot of Mastiff fans out there.
We do. They usually get adopted quite quickly.
They do.
We hope that happens for him. ID number 206-768, Cheese Loving Zeus. Watch what Bud can do. This is a smart one, you guys. Bud's owners couldn't keep him anymore. We've had a kind of a rash of owner turn-ins over the last week or so. Really super nice dogs. Bud, I love his name. Bud is a smart one. He does know down, too, but he's a little, you know, off his game with the cameras and everything. But that's a smart dog. And his notes on him say he's cat-friendly, dog-friendly, child-friendly, house-trained, loves to go on walks, travel in cars, he knows basic obedience, he's house-trained.
Does he have a check in any box other than fabulous?
There are no negatives,
whoa.
Terry. No negatives on this beautiful, beautiful dog.
This
and
is your dog's
six
dog.
6 years old, you know, easy keeper, they know the ropes, they know what they're doing, they don't take a bunch of work. I love Bud.
And he's good looking.
And he's handsome. That doesn't hurt.
Doesn't hurt. No.
We love our ugly ones too, but the handsome ones have a little bit of an advantage sometimes.
This guy needs to go fast.
Yes. And I think he will. 918-656.
Now, Deborah, this guy's name is worth his adoption. First of all.
Wow. Solovino.
Solovino.
I mean, I don't. Wow.
Wow.
You know, I don't know how they turned this dog in. And the reason I say that, and his owners couldn't keep him, you know, the same thing, kind of, you know, they got problems. They can't keep him. Okay, fine. He is so sweet. I just don't know. He gets in your lap and he puts his head against you and he leans back and just lays there.
Done deal.
He's just, he's terrific with other dogs. They also said he's great with cats and kids. He's house trained.
And he's got one ear up and
he's
one ear down.
He's got one ear up, one ear down. He's about seven, so he's a little bit of an older guy. But he is just a terrific, terrific dog who just deserves so much to get into a good, loving home. I love this dog. He's fantastic. So Solovino is for sale to whoever can buy him and take him home. 206-769. What a precious little dog. Cannot believe nobody's down here looking for this adorable dog. He came to us from Morro Bay.
He's nicely groomed.
He's nicely groomed. He's, you know, he looks like he's in really good shape. He's about 5 years old, we think.
Huh.
Came to us on the 10th of July, so just a few days ago. Gosh, he's a great little dog. Somebody come adopt him.
Yeah, you see, Deborah, he's got this nice novelty collar with, what does it have on that, bones on the collar? So is that going to get him anywhere?
It's not bones. The fanciness of the collar that counts. You got to have some writing. You got to have some tags hanging from it. All kinds of things will get a dog like this home very easily.
If you love me, write my phone on my collar, please.
Please do. But Benny's here, and he is up for adoption if nobody claims him. And so his ID number is 184-869, and he is a peach of a little guy. Well, this is a terrific little girl. She's been with us since the 9th of July. As you can see, we had a lot of dogs come in after the 4th of July. She's just a sweetheart. She's friendly. She's socialized. She's a good walker. She came from Paso. So somebody in Paso should be missing this little darling thing. But her ID number is 206-724, and she's waiting for someone to come adopt her.
And if nobody does, we're going to name her Ginger. Deborah, this is a face that makes me happy whenever I see him.
It is so cute. He's got that big old grin on his face. He's just a sweet salami head named Cam. We just love him. He came into the shelter on the 6th of July. Nobody's come to claim him. He's a kisser. He's sweet and affectionate. Really good on leash. You wouldn't think so to look at him, but he's great to walk. He seems to be house trained. Has his little girlfriend dogs down here he likes to play with. He's just a nice boy. Cam's ID number is 206-637. He's going to be a great companion for some family. Here's another big hunk of a guy. This one we're going to call Albert. Also came into the shelter. He came in on the 11th. And nobody's come to claim him. He's a nice dog. He's kind of calm. He's fairly easygoing. Just seems to be house trained. A nice guy that, you know, nobody's looking for. It just really kind of breaks my heart. His ID number is 206-773. He came to us from Paso Robles, and he's beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. We're going to call him Albert. Napoleon, some conglomeration of some kind of dogs. I'm not exactly sure exactly what he is. Oh, he just spotted himself there. I don't think he likes the looks of it. No, I don't like that dog. I'm getting away from him. He's small. He's like, I don't know, maybe 30 pounds, something like that. About 2 years old. And needs a new home. So if you need a smallish, not too small, not too big dog, maybe Napoleon's the one for you. 206-378. This is Napoleon. Sarah's another part of that rash of owner turn-ins we've had over the last week or two. 7 years old. They couldn't keep her any longer. Sarah's a nice dog. She's kind of scared here. She doesn't much like the shelter environment very much. But she's a good girl. She's a sweet dog. And someone, please give this dog a home for the rest of her life. Sarah's ID number is 206-580. This is Steve. He is a herding dog whose owners could no longer keep him. Steve is a nice all-around good dog, very affectionate, very smart, highly intelligent, does kind of have that herding instinct, so he has a tendency to want to chase after people riding bikes and stuff like that, so he needs to be in a place where he can't do that.
And he's only 7 months old.
He's 7 months old. He's a baby, so some training could also take care of those problems. He's dog friendly though. He likes kids. He's house trained. He's all around good boy.
Obviously likes people. Doesn't
yes, he does.
Leave Judy.
He's loving Judy.
Mm-hmm.
Steve's ID number is 206-478. Oh, we got a scared guy here. He came to us on the 16th of July, which, 9th of July. I was going to say it's not even the 16th yet. 9th of July from San Miguel. And he seems to be a very nice dog, but he is scared to death here. Poor guy.
Once again, volunteers will turn this around.
Yes, they will. And Colette, the dog you saw earlier, will help too because she's already his play buddy. So you got to make friends down here. You make them with two legs and you make them with four legs, and this guy's going to do fine. ID number 206720, really nice dog. Aw, this is Winnie. She just got spayed, so she's a little out of it. She's an English bulldog, about 3 years old. She's a little bit of a nervous Nelly. She's really sweet, but, probably an adult household or household with older children would be better. Little kids would just freak her out, I think.
Now, she's standing up there, her front legs, that's as tall as she is. She's very low to the ground. She can't see the back, but the front, that will give you an idea of her height.
But you know what? She's going to corner great.
Yeah.
So she's going to be great for somebody. 3-year-old Winnie is so cute. Just got spayed, ready to get the heck out of here. ID number 206260. How cute is that?
Okay, here we go with the cat section of the program. You're looking right now at Chico, and he is so handsome. Did you spot those gorgeous blue eyes? If he looks into the camera, you'll see what I mean. He's beautifully marked. He is a Calico Point Siamese, we're calling him. I think that's a new one in the breed books. Chico is neutered. He's just about 6 years old, and he is absolutely gorgeous. Friendly, friendly guy. Look at him, how he sits right up tall there, not afraid of anything. He's confident, he's cool, he's collected, and he's as handsome as they get. Chico's ID number is 206-767. Chico. Here we've got two playful kittens in the same cage, so if you're looking for two cats that get along together, you're going to love these two. We have the male, who's sitting right up there, nice and tall. His name is Kinkajou, and he is 3 months old. And in the back, we have Fanny. She is 3 months old also, brother and sister. So if you want two cats that get along, these two are great for you. Kinkajou's number, 205-242, and Fanny's number, 205-361. And guess what? Because these two cats are black, they qualify for the black cat rebate. Yes, each of them. You get $25 back on your adoption fee when you adopt either one of these black cats and any of the black cats that we have here. So think about these two, Kinkajou and Fanny. ID numbers 205361 Fanny, 205242 Kinkajou. Well, as you can see, it's a slow day at the shelter here. All these kittens get to do is sleep. Every now and again, they get up and play, but this is no place for kittens. These guys are ready to go into your home if you would like them. We have Tina, who is the tabby there, just about 3 months old, ID number 206272, and a most delightful black and white whose name is Tuba, ID number 206274. Once again, these two do well together, so if you want two and quite different looking cats who go together, Tina and Tuba would love to go into your home together. Consider Tina 206272 or Tuba 206274. I don't know what you think, but I think this is our Miss America of the shelter. Oh my goodness, she is so beautiful. Her name is Flora, and that's a very nice name for her, so pretty. She's just about a year old, and her ID number is 206563. And guess what? Half of her adoption fee has already been paid. So if you fall in love with Flora, half her fee is paid for you. ID number 206563, Flora. Here's another pretty girl. We have a lot of good-looking cats today. This is Maisie. She's just about 2 years old and I think very interestingly marked. She has half of her adoption fee paid too. That's right. Half of her fee goes back into your pocket if you decide to adopt her. And wait a minute. I think Maisie and Flora would go well together. Maisie's ID number 193236. That's Maisie, half adoption fee paid. Here are two darling cutie pies. We've got a lot of kittens ready to go. This is an example of two of them. We've got heavy poundage of kitten here, so you've got to lessen our load and our weight and take some kittens out of here while they're still weighing not so much. Here we have Latte and Espresso. Guess who's who? The Latte is the buff one. That little boy, is just about 2 months old, and his ID number is 205945. And Espresso, right behind, she's a female, ID number 205946. Latte and Espresso, two cats that get along great together, and don't their names fit each other? Yes, they do. Latte, 205945, and Espresso, 205946. One on top of the other cats, we've got Misty and Mia. I really, really think these two would go well together. We have Misty, who's got white on her, ID number 206116, and Mia, who's all tabby, no white, ID number 206117. Misty and Mia, again, these two will do well together. Here we have two little black kittens. We named them Alice and Ralph. And these two qualify for the Black Cat Rebate. Yeah, remember what I told you earlier in the show? If you adopt a black cat, $25 goes back into your pocket with a rebate for the black cat. Ralph is ID number 206535 and Alice 206540. They go well together. Two pretty tabbies. We have Roger and Maria. Roger is a tabby on white. Has a white on his chest. He's just 4 months old and he's ready to go. ID number 206037. And Maria, ID number 206008. These two tabbies would do well together if you want two together. Roger and Maria. These two guys are having a riot playing together. You've got Splash and you've got Blacktop. Splash is the black and white in front, and Blacktop is the black one behind. Lots of fun with these two. I guarantee you're going to have a lot of fun at home if you take one of them or two of them. Blacktop 205617 and Splash 205987. Come and get them. Kind of looks like Tilly's ready for her close-up here. Yes, she is. She came out to meet and greet. This is a beautiful black and white tuxedo. She's just about 5 years old, and her ID number is 206677. Tilly. Well, here we've got two cutie pies. They are tabbies or tabby torties. In the front, we have Bessie, just 4 months old, ID number 206648. And in the back, we have Queenie, ID number 206647. And great news, we're having a kitten palooza. All cats and kittens on July 25th are going to be available for adoption at half price. That's right, you heard it. Half price, July 25th. Every cat, every kitten down here during the Kitten Palooza, half price. Okay, we've got two cats living together here in this cage, but my good friend Bon Bon out here wants to steal the show, and well, she should. She is the most unusual color that I've ever seen in a cat that we've had here, honestly. This cat is going to be the talk of the town around where you live if you take her. As you can see, she is absolutely chocolate. If you come and see her in person, you will see she has some tabby markings. And she's very lively and fun. Bon Bon's number, 206734, and her pal in the back, a nice tabby, ID number 206735. And these two cats have been together since they've been little kittens, and so they do great together. Kitty and Bon Bon. So these two are our Sweetie Pie representatives of all the kittens we have down here. We have a bazillion kittens down here, and we've got about another 50 or 60 out in foster, just waiting for you to see, fall in love, and adopt. Yes, we do. So, Kitten Palooza, put it on your calendar, 25th of July, 11 till 4, down here at the shelter. Meet these kittens, meet the cats, and please, please take somebody home.